One more type of chemical substances used by us in our daily life is cleansing agent, or they are also called as cleansing agents. So what are cleansing agents? Here, the chemical substances which are used to clean fiber, fabric and skin are called as cleansing agents. So these are a type of essential chemical substances in our everyday life. Here, these are also called as detergents. Also called as detergents. Here, two types of detergents are used by us. They are soaps and second one, synthetic detergents. Soaps and synthetic detergents. Remember, the soaps are produced from CH2O, C double bond O, C17H35. Similarly, CHO, C double bond O, C17H35. Similarly, CH2O, C double bond O, C17H35. It is a glycerol based long fatty acid chain of stearic acid. During the preparation of soaps, the fatty acids or oils are used by us such as palmitic acid, oleic acid and stearic acid type of fatty acids or oils are used during the preparation. Here, the glycerol derivative of triester derivative of glycerol, which consists of a long hydrocarbon chain, when reacted with sodium or potassium salts, sodium or potassium bases, there the reaction expected between these three and produces the three ester functional group undergoes hydrolysis in the presence of sodium hydroxide and produces C17H35 C double bond O Na, plus it releases the formation of glycerol as side product CH2OH, glycerol. The name of the compound is sodium stearate. We can call it as a soap. During the preparation, the derivatives of glycerol or triester derivatives of glycerol in which a long hydrocarbon chains present are interacted with sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, because sodium salts and potassium salts only soluble in water. This is the reason why during the preparation of soaps we have to use or we have to produce either sodium salts or potassium salts. And now the esters on hydrolysis with sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide produces soap. And this reaction is called as saponification reaction. Saponification reaction means the chemical reaction involved in the preparation of soap is saponification reaction. Here, various types of soaps are available, but before going to explain various types of soaps, we have to learn those soaps which consist of potassium salts are soft than sodium salts. This is the reason why the toilet soaps are consist of potassium salts, whereas the detergent bars are consist of sodium salts. Okay, due to soft character of soaps which consist of potassium salts, they are used in the preparation of toilet soaps. Now let us learn about types of soaps. Types of soaps. Remember, various types of soaps are available. The first one is toilet bar or toilet soap. So here, at the time of preparation of toilet soaps, the more care is necessary and high quality oils, edible oils, and fats are used for the preparation of toilet soap. In addition to high quality oils and soaps, oils and fats, we have to add some coloring substances and perfumes to this at the time of its preparation. Similarly, medicated soaps. Here, these soaps generally consist of some medical properties, medicinal properties. Remember, such soaps are like Dettol soap and some liquid hand washes, like this comes under this category, medicated soaps. These medicated soaps are consist of rosin type of chemical substances. Upon addition of rosin type of chemical substances, they can stop or they can kill the microorganisms during this, and they are called as medicated soaps. So this rosin is added at the time of preparation of soaps. Similarly, some float soaps, the soaps which are having floating character in water, float soaps, are also used by producing air bubbles in their preparation. So remember, in all the soap preparations, first they reacted with sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. During the saponification, they release sodium stearate with the addition of some chemical substances like glycerol. Here, the produced soap is available in colloidal state. The colloidal state of soap first converted into precipitate by adding some sodium chloride type of salts. So from this, the glycerol will be eliminated out from this precipitate by using steam distillation. Sometimes the transparent soaps are also produced during the preparation. These transparent soaps are produced from adding excess amount of ethanol. After preparation of that transparent soap, the excess amount of ethanol will be eliminated out. So this is various types of soaps: toilet soaps, medicated soaps, float soaps, and similarly like transparent soaps, etc. In all these soaps, especially which are used in the purpose of bathing, the used salts are potassium salts. Second one, the most important concept in case of hard water. Generally, we are with two types of water. It may be soft water or hard water. Due to presence of calcium salts and magnesium salts, the water will become hardness. The water will become hard character, will show hard character. And come to this, generally, soaps reacts with hard water, or when dissolved in hard water cannot produce foam. Instead of this foam, they produce precipitate. Whenever the soaps are dissolved in water, when they produce foam, then only it used as better cleansing agent. But when soaps are dissolved in hard water, instead of foam, they releases or they produces a precipitate. The reason for this is, when the soaps are interacted with, like C17, H35, COONA, sodium stearate, when reacted with hard water. So remember, hard water consists of calcium chloride, calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate type of salts. Now these reacts with this and produces some C17, H35, COO, taken twice, CA, plus 2NaCl. So it is remained as precipitate. Due to this In case of hard water, the soaps are not preferable as cleansing agent. So to overcome this problem, the next type of cleansing agents are available. They are synthetic detergents or simply called as detergents. So let us learn the next topic as detergents. Here, not like reagents, not like soaps, the detergents can also produce foam in hard water. That means the foam or good quality of foam will be expected from detergent by dissolving it in soft water as well as hard water. The three types of detergents are widely available in daily life. They are cationic detergents. Second one is anionic detergents. Third one, non-ionic detergents. The three types of detergents are cationic detergents, anionic detergents, and non-ionic detergents. Let us have benzyl sulfonates, that means sodium salts of benzene sulfate